Hello, I'm KCRI 3 meteorologist Dirk Verdorn, and we are seeing some changes come about again, and it's going to include some cooler temperatures. Taking a look here, satellite view, I'm going to go ahead and draw some lines showing you some boundaries. So this is where we have cooler air that's been moving back our direction. So this pocket is where the cold air is, and this is going to be sliding into Northern California over the next couple of days. And so we are going to notice a little bit of a cool down as we get into Sunday, and then by Monday, that's when the core of this colder air moves through. We'll have temperatures dropping back into the upper 50s again, it looks like, by Monday afternoon. And then we'll start warming up, and it looks like we could see some more significant warming as we head into next weekend. So we're just a week away from temperatures that are going to be climbing into the 70s. In fact, we could see some mid-70s down the road, but we'll get to that in a bit. First, let's go ahead and talk about the chance for some rain and snow. We are going to see that chance with us. We are looking at tonight. We may see a few little flurries and showers. I don't think it's going to be too much of a problem as we go through tonight. Another feature we're going to notice as we go through Sunday is we are going to see an increase in wind. In fact, the Sierra has wind advisories that are posted because we're expecting winds, again, in the valleys, in the low-lying areas and through the Sierra, anywhere from 20 to 30 miles per hour sustained with gusts up over 40, 50 plus miles per hour. In fact, over the passes, we could have wind gusts that get up over 80 miles per hour. So it's going to be pretty windy on Sunday. So if you have plans to go up maybe and try to enjoy some of the snow or skiing or things like that, it's not going to be the best conditions because of the wind. And we will see a few flurries, but not really through the morning. You can see there's not a lot of activity. In fact, we have some breaks. It's going to be later in the afternoon and on into the evening that we start to see that chance for snow on the increase. And this is when we're going to see the best chance for some accumulation of snowfall over the passes. So if you are going to be traveling Sunday night, that's when we may see chain controls go up. So just be aware of that in your plans. And you can see it shifts a little bit to the south as we get into Monday morning. So again, the bulk of the snow coming through Sunday night, early Monday morning, and then we just see some more scattered showers out here. In fact, we may even see a few thunderstorms along the northern coast of California. That's about it. We'll see a few more on and off again showers as we go through Monday afternoon and on into a Monday night. Here we are, 8:30 p.m. Valley spots looking fairly clear. So the mountains will get the activity. Valley's not going to have a lot happening. As we get into Tuesday, another little wave comes through, and you can see some more snow in the mountains and some scattered showers along the coast of California and over the coastal mountains. So as far as going through Sunday night and into Monday, again, we're not going to see a lot of snow, but we will see anywhere from 3 to 6 inches, I think, over the passes. So be aware that we could see those amounts. And when you get that much snow, wouldn't be surprised to get some chain controls up there. Snow levels are going to stay fairly high above, well, not high, but we're looking at snow levels basically ranging up over 4,000 feet, between 3 to 4,000 feet at times with some of the heavier showers coming through. Futurecast showing us a pocket of cold air and just these little waves that kind of come through as we go through Sunday into Monday morning. Again, valley not expecting a whole lot, but the mountains will get those showers, get the north winds picking up on Monday. And we'll still have some north wind on into Tuesday, but it should taper off a little bit. Wednesday, cooler air starts to modify, starts to get a little warmer. And then as we get into Thursday, a few showers along the coast. And then Friday, those temperatures, look at that, high pressure starts to build in, and if that can put itself right over top of us like it shows here, then we'll have temperatures well into the 70s. We should be in well into the mid-70s, it looks like, by next Saturday. If that holds true, again, that's 7 days away, so things can change, but this is what it looks like right now. Temperatures in the mid to lower 60s on Sunday, so a little bit cooler than Saturday. Bigger drop in temperatures comes in on Monday with the winds. Those winds will be picking up. We're looking at wind speeds anywhere from 10 to 20 or more in the valley, so that'll be noticeable. The winds taper off, temperatures start warming. We're back in the mid-60s by Wednesday, upper 60s by Thursday. Come Friday, we'll be pushing up around 70 degrees, and we could reach into the mid-70s with mostly sunny skies by next Saturday. That's a look at your weather. For all your weather needs, make sure you turn to KCRA.